Now, what we have done is, we have used RE at the emitter, which will provide negative feedback in DC analysis, adding stability of the Q point. That is the use of RE in the circuit. It is very important to use RE in the circuit. I'll repeat that. Because of RE, the DC stability is increasing. But at the same time, we are having something called as AC analysis. So we must know what is the effect of RE during AC analysis. Now, this is a circuit diagram of transistor having RE or emitter resistor. What we have done is, we have short circuited all DC batteries present in the circuit. Now, circuit diagram will look like this. This is input AC applied or called as source voltage. This is actual input across transistor called as VI, and this is feedback voltage across RE. Now, first of all, we will write about DC analysis. In DC analysis, because of RE, stability is increasing. Now, let's see what is happening in AC analysis. I'll apply KVL from base to emitter. If we apply KVL from base to emitter, we will get equation as Vs minus Vi minus Vf is equal to 0. And hence, Vi is equal to Vs minus Vf. Now, I'll write where Vs is source voltage, Vi is input voltage, and Vf is feedback voltage. So, where Vs is nothing but source voltage, Vi is input voltage, and Vf is feedback voltage. In this equation, Vi is actual input to the transistor, which is given by Vs minus Vf. But as IC increases, Vf will increase. And because of which, actual input applied to the transistor, that is Vi, will decrease. This is very important point. If actual input to the transistor is decreases, then output voltage of transistor will decrease. Hence, output voltage will decrease. The main use of transistor is to amplify the signal, but we are getting less amplification due to presence of RE while AC analysis. Now, this is a very problematic case. We required RE, at the same time, we don't require RE. Then how to deal with this? This is a very, very important question. Because RE is added in the circuit to provide DC stability. If we remove the RE, then DC stability will decrease. And if we have the RE, DC stability will increase, but amplification will decrease. To avoid this situation, what we can do is, we want RE during DC, but we don't want RE during AC. As simple as that. For that, there we can do only one thing. We can add a capacitor in front of RE. What will happen because of that? Let's see. What I'm saying is, suppose this is your RE or emitter resistor. Let's add a capacitor across it. The name of capacitor is C. Now, during DC analysis, capacitor will be open circuited and hence RE will be available. For DC, capacitor is open circuit. Hence, the circuit diagram will become means RE is present during DC analysis. For AC, capacitor is short-circuited. Hence, circuit diagram will become like this. Now, if current is flowing, it will flow from this path during AC because current follows minimum resistance path. If current is flowing from the RE or the emitter, don't say RE, if current is flowing from emitter, then it will be flowing from this loop. And hence, RE as good as not present in the circuit. And hence, amplification will increase. This is how we can bypass RE from the circuit by using bypass capacitor at the emitter. This is the basic of bypassing RE from the circuit. We will bypass RE in order to get high amplification during AC analysis. Thank you.